Peace and salutations, family, and welcome to another edition of First Word from the Pastor Study. I am the Reverend Dr. Mark Carter Pierce, Senior Pastor and Founder of All Christ Love Ministries. I am so glad that you're with us today. I can promise you, on this fourth Sunday in April, I can promise you that there is a word from the Lord on today, amen. And I think it's something that you need to hear, amen. We won't be before you too long, amen. But I'm going to ask right now that you might join me and stand in the gap as I approach the throne of grace, amen. Merciful God, again, I come before you in the name of Jesus, thanking and praising you for this day, O God, and just one more opportunity to do something right in your sight in the name of Jesus, God. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus with great thanksgiving right now, Father. I thank you in advance for what you've done, what you're doing, and what you're about to do in the name of Jesus, God. Now, Father, I pray that you would sit me down and you stand up. Decrease me and increase you, none of me and all of you. Instruct my mind and direct my vocal cords on what to say and do before these, your sheep. And transform me into the man that you would have me be in Christ Jesus, God. I pray, Father, right now in the name of Jesus, God, that you move through this digital realm like a mighty rushing wind, and you have your way on this morning, God, in the name of Jesus, Father. I pray that you open up our minds to your divine wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, O God, in the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I pray, Father, that the words that come forth today do not fall on deaf ears, O God, but be imbued in the hearts and the minds of the listeners, O God, so that we may not be just hearers of the word, but doers of the word, in the name of Jesus. Again, I say, Father, have your way, O God, in the name of Jesus. And Father, please correct this, your imperfect servant, O God, this broken vessel. Create in me a clean heart and renew a right and steadfast spirit within me, O God. For it's me who's standing in the need of prayer. As I give you all honor, glory, and praise, it is in the mighty and powerful name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth I pray and say amen. Today I'm coming to you once again from the book of Matthew. I know you probably say to yourself, why does he always come from the Gospels? Why does he love the Gospels so much? Simply put, you need to understand that at this time, we are in the New Testament, the new covenant that was forged when Christ was resurrected. That's what we're living in. We're living in a time of grace, amen, so that we can prepare for the great by and by and to be with Jesus in the kingdom of heaven with God once again, amen. These are the instructions in the Gospels. These are the most important instructions because they came from Jesus himself. That's why I'm so focused on that, amen. And I'm coming from the book of Matthew today. We're going to be in chapter 16, verses 24 through 28. It's going to be real short, but I think the message is going to be quite resounding, amen. Verses 24 through 28, I'll be reading from the New King James Version. And thus says the Lord, then Jesus said to his disciples, if anyone desires to come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever desires to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. For what profit is it to a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Or what will a man give in exchange for his soul? For the Son of Man will come in his glory of his Father with his angels, and then he will reward each according to his works. Assuredly, I say to you, there are some standing here who shall not taste death till they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. Amen. Blessed is the reading of the word of the Lord. I need folks to understand one thing today. Maybe a little difficult for you to hear, but the truth is the truth. But when it comes to the kingdom of heaven, sadly, a lot of people, you will not see them there. The Bible even declares, Jesus himself says, many that you see saying, Lord, Lord, today you will not see in the kingdom of heaven. Because the truth of the matter is, everybody can't dance. Everybody can't dance. Everybody can't dance. When you go to the party, and I know a lot of y'all been to parties before. Sure you do. Some of y'all still going. But, you know, sometimes you just can't dance to every record. You can't get up for every song. And when it comes to the kingdom of heaven, everybody isn't going to be able to dance to that tune. You know, it's not easy. And I want you to understand the first reason for that is, if you look in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 1, verse 5, God himself testifies. He says of us, he says, I knew you before I formed you in the womb. And then he says, I sanctified you. Now, I believe that some of us may not have an understanding of what that word sanctified means. Some of us might believe that when you sanctified, it means you got the Holy Ghost in you. It doesn't exactly mean that. The translation of the word sanctified reads as set apart. God has set you apart because he loves you and he created you and he made you, and that spirit man that's within you is created in his own image, amen. He loves us because he created us. He has every hair on our head counted, amen. And he set us apart from the animals, amen. From the tree, from the bush, from the fish, from the zebra and the goat, amen. He set us apart because he loves us. And he wants us to be with him. We are his creations in terms of the fact that, praise God, we have the power of free will. We have the power of thought and reason. And he wants us to be with him in the kingdom of heaven to exhibit those gifts of which he gave us. Glory be to God. We are set apart. That's how we are sanctified. If you want to ride, okay, if you want to dance, amen, you got to be sanctified. That doesn't mean that you got the Holy Ghost and you know how to jump around the room and carry on. No, it does not. What it means is that God has already put you to the side and you've recognized him. Now you are special. You need to write down on a piece of paper and look at it every day. Just remind yourself that you are special, amen. If you know Jesus and you are trying to dance at this party, you are sanctified, you are special, you've been set apart, amen. Another way that it works is, another point that you need to understand is in order to ride, you must answer the call. Matthew 22, I believe it's verse 14. Jesus says, many are called, but the chosen are few. Let me break that bread for you. Let me cut you a nice slice and put some butter on it. Amen. When Jesus says, many are called and the chosen are few, understand this. That, praise God, every human being has been called by Jesus. Because God made every one of us. And God wants each and every one of us to come back home to him. So we have all been called. Many have been called. Now the chosen is something different. The chosen, who are few, are those that God has called into leadership. Those are the ones who you might refer to as your apostles, your bishops, your prophets, your prophetess, your evangelists, your elder, your pastor, your minister, your deacon, your deaconess. Those who have been called into leadership by God to direct and protect his sheep. Those are the chosen. God selects them particularly, discriminately, because He built them. He built us for this particular task. And it's a demanding task. And we're going to talk about that in a minute, too. It's a demanding task. But God built us for this task. He said He would not put anything on us that we couldn't bear. And it's true. We're the ones that have a problem understanding what we can bear, because the minute that things go wrong, we're the first ones that want to give up. Amen. But God has strengthened us in ways that we could never imagine. You know, we've got to stop putting things in a box and thinking that God, because He doesn't satisfy our five senses, is ignorant of our being. Amen. Because He is not. He created us. So the chosen are the ones that God built and specifically selected to be in leadership. But the many that have been called is each and every human being. However, there are some that just don't answer the call. There are some that are not willing. They're not willing to do what Jesus says in the scripture here. They're not desiring, they're desiring to come after Him, but they're not willing to deny themselves. They're not willing to take up their cross and follow Him. Because it's all about them. It's all about that material stuff that they used to. Amen. That's where they're at. That's the stuff that they're about right now. It's not about Jesus. It's about them. Amen. Kind of takes us back to what I told you before about selfishness. Amen. Because Jesus, whenever He met you, Jesus would say, "What can I do for you? How can I help you?" Jesus was selfless, and that's how He was without sin. But we are intrinsically selfish, as just a matter of the degree which keeps us out of the kingdom of heaven, because every selfish act is the basis of sin. I don't feel like going to church because I worked hard yesterday and I am tired. I don't feel like worshiping God because right now I got to get my party on. Oh, it's okay if I drink because it takes away the struggles and the pains that I'm going through today. So what if it alters my personality and makes me beat the hell out of my wife? Selfishness. You can't ride when you're selfish, because when you're selfish, you ain't ever gonna answer the call. You can't ride. Everybody can't ride. Everybody can't dance, man. But everybody can't ride. Listen, that car only so big. Everybody can't ride. Another point that I want to make to you about this thing is very simple. Many can't ride because they've been taught wrong. Or in particular, you know, Jesus tells us, He said that we got to enter through the narrow gate. And some folks, either they've been taught wrong, or they're not willing to enter through that narrow gate. Yeah. Look here. You see, I'm sorry, but you know, when you got some folks, you got some unscrupulous folks out there, Jesus Himself said that you're going to encounter many wolves in sheep's clothing, amen. They're not trying to tell you the truth. To be frank with you, if your pastor don't hurt your feelings here and there, when you wrong, if he don't tell you the truth about yourself, if he's only trying to, he or she rather, is only trying to tell you what you're trying to hear, then something wrong. Something is wrong. Something is wrong. God Himself says only a fool rebukes chastisement. You'll find that in Proverbs. God Himself says only a fool rebukes chastisement. We ain't perfect, man. We are not perfect. I'm here to tell you. I'm chief among them. I'm an imperfect vessel. Broken. Messed up. Got issues. I'm just a guy that God uses sometimes to speak the truth. Only a perfect vessel would rebuke chastisement, because
if you're honest about it, you know, we're all in the flesh. If you're honest about it, you know we all make mistakes. And mistakes require what? Correction and chastisement. And God will deliver. Glory be to God. But some of us have been taught wrong. Some of us have been taught that when we gave our heart to Jesus and our right hand to the pastor, we were taught, yes, that is true, that the old man is washed away and a new creature is born. But did you think God is going to do all the heavy lifting? You ain't got to do nothing? First order of business is you better start praying to God to change you. Prayer changes things. It starts with you. Change us first so that we may receive what God has to give us and to tell us, amen. Because a lot of times we ain't built for that. Yeah, we're taught wrong. I once had somebody say to me, flesh and blood human being like myself, in the flesh, in the world, said to me that they do not sin because they got Jesus in them. Baby, Jesus ain't going to be in a house full of sin and your flesh, and the Bible declares that the flesh is sin. Jesus is not going to be in you because you're a sinner. But Jesus will save you from your sin. I know y'all don't want to hear that. I know y'all don't want to believe that. I know some of y'all don't want to accept the truth. Have you ever noticed that it's so hard? Elton John made a song about 30, 40 years ago, something like that. He said, sorry seems to be the hardest word. Have you ever noticed that it's so hard to apologize for our stuff when we know we did it wrong? It's so hard for us to admit that we are wrong about things. We can never be wrong. We always got to be right. That's just the way it is, right? That's how people are. Because we've been taught wrong. We've been taught that it's okay to be always right. And especially in the church. Yeah. Listen, we have been taught so wrong. We've been taught to step over people because we right. We is righteous. We're not righteous, we're self-righteous. And that's a bad thing when you allow your mind. When God, Jesus himself said, you being evil, and called us a wicked generation. Jesus is the one that knows who we are because he is God. But no, we can't be that. We hate to be that because it's something that makes us low and bad. We hate that idea because it's all about us. We got to keep our self-esteem together. Huh? Everybody can't ride, man. Everybody can't ride. And then some folks, again, just don't want to go through that narrow gate because it's just too rough. That life of suffering, man, that just doesn't appeal. It doesn't appeal. Jesus said, for whoever desires to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. We are so short-sighted that we cannot see what's on the other side of the kingdom of heaven. Check this out. He says, for what profit is it to a man if he gains the whole world? Mercedes Benz's, fat gold, amen. Designer jeans, praise God. Snakeskin cowboy boots, amen. The house on the hill, fat bank account, amen. What good is having all that? When you're going to lose your very soul when, you know, I've never seen a hearse, and I work in the funeral profession, I never saw a hearse followed by a Brinks truck, amen. Never saw that. Never. Because when you go, and trust me, we're going to leave from here one day. Because this body ain't built forever. We got to leave here. And when that takes place,
There's going to be a judgment. And then we're going to find out who's going to ride. Some of us are going to ride up to the kingdom of heaven. Some of us are going to die. Our spirit is going to go with death and hell into the lake of fire. We're not going to have eternal life. Because it was too hard, because we were taught wrong. You got to understand again that in order to rise, you got to be sanctified. You got to be set apart. God set you apart. So the basics are there. You got to be sanctified. You got to be set apart. But you also got to accept it. And when Jesus says many are called, you better be ready to answer the call. Yeah. You better be ready. You got to be ready to pick up your cross and follow him in there. Don't follow me. Follow him. He is the way, the truth, and the light. And the other thing is, you better learn some. A lot of folks ain't going to ride because they've been taught wrong. Or because they don't want to go through that narrow gate. You better learn today how to go through that narrow gate. You better learn today what the right deal is. You better be ready to understand that you're not perfect. You better get off your self-righteous high horse. You better start practicing some humility if you want to ride. Because that train filling up soon. And let me just close on this particular thing. Jesus said that he has come with a sword. He will separate fathers from sons, mothers from daughters, parents from children. Some of these spouses can't ride because they ain't ready. Some of these future spouses. God said you got to be equally yoked. But some folks, man, some folks think that they built for this, but they're not. They can be, but they got to give it up. You got to throw in the towel to God. You got to give it up all the way. All the way. God himself, he says, I'm a jealous God. You shall put no other God before me. That means your boo, your money, your car, your job, your house, your kids. Nothing comes before God. Your spiritual relationship must come first with your Father. Because without that, you will have nothing else. Today is the day. Maybe you don't really know him. Maybe you've been taught wrong. Maybe you never met him. But I want to offer you that opportunity today. Or maybe you were in the house of God before and with some folks that were taught wrong and they did you wrong and you got disillusioned with God and fell back. And I'm here today to bring you back home if you want to come back home. It's got to be in you. You ain't going to do nothing unless it comes from the heart today. It's got to come from the heart. We're trying to do this thing right. We're going to start this thing right today. And if you're ready to come from the heart, amen, I need you to repeat these words after me. It's real simple. You don't need to be around nobody else. You ain't even got to say them out loud. Just mean them from your heart. That's all I need you to do. We're going to get you going right now so that you can be in that car, so that you can make this ride. Are you ready? Repeat after me from your heart. Father, I confess that I have sinned and fallen short of your glory. But I believe in Jesus. I believe he lived a life without sin and died for my sins. And you raised him from death. And now he's in heaven interceding on my behalf. Jesus, come into my life, come into my heart. Be my Lord, my Savior, my Master, and my friend. Holy Ghost, seal me until the day of redemption. In Jesus' name, amen. If you said those words today for the first time and meant them from your heart, let me be the first to welcome you into the body of Christ. You are now an heir of God and a joint heir with Christ. And you are also available for the benefits that come thereof. If you did so today, I need you to email me at allchristlove@gmail.com. That's allchristlove@gmail.com. And also, if you said it today and meant it from your heart, I want to welcome you back. And I need to have an email from you too. I want to welcome you back to the body of Christ. We missed you, we love you, and we need you because there's so much work to be done. I need to do a little housekeeping real quick with you. First order business, we are a COVID church right now. We're online only, but eventually a time will come when we are back to face to face. But if you start with me, I'm not going to leave you hanging. And through our website, we will have live streaming of our services and our tele-Bible study. And when you email me, I'll be glad to send you a link to that tele-Bible study. And we'll also let you know what's going on with the website so that when we do start back, you will be able to participate with us. The whole thing is, if you're going to do this thing right, we got to do it right. And the way that we do it right is you got to be involved with a Bible preaching and teaching church, not a money-based church, not a give church, a Bible preaching and teaching church, amen. And we're here for you, and we'd love to have you. But if you need something that's more local to you, that's fine too. Just make sure it's a Bible preaching and teaching church. Secondly, for any long-term relationship to exist, like the one that God wants us to have with Him, love must be present. Now, God has love for us beyond all bounds because He created us, He knows us. He says to us that He has every hair on our head counted. He knows us that well. But we have to get to that point because that's what He desires, is us to love Him as much as He loves us. And the only way to do that is through His Word. So I suggest to you, you need to get a Bible. I prefer the New King James Version, but that might be a little stiff for you. You might want to start with the New International Version in order to get your understanding. Amen? When you read it, don't read it like you would any other book. You have to pray first that God will open your heart and your mind to His divine wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. You read some scripture, you meditate on it, and let the Holy Spirit tell you what it means. Because He's the only one who can make it make sense for you. The Bible was written to confound the wicked, amen. That's why a lot of folks don't understand it. Amen. And to supplement that, you also need a Bible preaching and teaching pastor to help you out with that. And on every Wednesday night via Google Meet, which will soon be done through our website, we have our tele-Bible study, which is at 6 p.m. Mountain Time, 7 p.m. Central Time, and 8 p.m. Eastern Time. And we'd love to have you. When you email me, I will be more than happy to send you the link to our Google Meet. It's for 1 hour. And I guarantee you will learn something. You're going to learn the right way. Amen. Lastly, I want you to know that this ministry, we believe what the scripture says, because we're Bible preaching and teaching, And the scripture says, do as your heart has purposed, for God loves a cheerful giver. We don't tithe here. We feel that if God motivates you to give to us, then you'll give to us. We're not asking you for it.